there is no current cure for chronic kidney disease. However, some therapies can help control the signs and symptoms, reduce the risk of complications, and slow the progression of the disease. Patients with chronic kidney disease typically need to take a large number of medications. Treatments include anemia treatment. Hemoglobin is the substance in red blood cells that carries vital oxygen around the body. If hemoglobin levels are low, the patient has anemia. Some kidney disease patients with anemia will require blood transfusions. A patient with kidney disease will usually have to take iron supplements, either in the form of daily ferrous sulfate tablets or occasionally in the form of injections. Phosphate balance. People with kidney disease may not be able to eliminate phosphate from their body properly. Patients will be advised to reduce their nutritional phosphate intake. This usually means reducing consumption of dairy products, red meat, eggs, and fish. High blood pressure. High blood pressure is a common problem for patients with chronic kidney disease. It is important to bring the blood pressure down to protect the kidneys, and subsequently slow down the progression of the disease. Skin itching. Antihistamines, such as chlorpheniramine, may help alleviate symptoms of itching. Anti-sickness medications. If toxins build up in the body because the kidneys don't work properly, patients may feel sick, nausea. Medications such as cyclizine or metoclopramide help relieve sickness. NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. NSAIDs, such as aspirin or ibuprofen, should be avoided and only taken if a doctor recommends them. End-stage treatment. This is when the kidneys are functioning at less than 10 to 15% of normal capacity. Measures used so far, diet, medications, and treatments controlling underlying causes, are no longer enough. The kidneys of patients with end-stage kidney disease cannot keep up with the waste and fluid elimination process on their own. The patient will need dialysis or a kidney transplant in order to survive. Most doctors will try to delay the need for dialysis or a kidney transplant for as long as possible because they carry the risk of potentially serious complications. Kidney dialysis. Peritoneal dialysis is a treatment option for chronic kidney disease. There are two main types of kidney dialysis. Each type also has subtypes. The two main types are hemodialysis. Blood is pumped out of the patient's body and goes through a dialyzer and artificial kidney. The patient undergoes hemodialysis about 3 times per week. Each session lasts for at least 3 hours. Experts now recognize that more frequent sessions result in a better quality of life for the patient, but modern home-use dialysis machines are making this more regular use of hemodialysis possible. Peritoneal dialysis. The blood is filtered in the patient's own abdomen, in the peritoneal cavity, which contains a vast network of tiny blood vessels. A catheter is implanted into the abdomen, into which a dialysis solution is infused and drained out for as long as is necessary to remove waste and excess fluid. Kidney transplant. The kidney donor and recipient should have the same blood type, cell surface proteins, and antibodies, in order to minimize the risk of rejection of the new kidney. Siblings or very close relatives are usually the best types of donors. If a living donor is not possible, the search will begin for a cadaver donor, dead person.